Crazy right now, but trust me, once I get the mega bun, I think it'll look okay. I think. Okay, so as you can tell, I don't look like my typical self. That's because I feel like I have a lot of hair on my face. One second. Now that is because I today want to do a Megan Fox makeup tutorial. So Megan Fox was a total icon in the early 2000s and still kind of is. Okay, she is. But anyways, people love her. I always see a lot of Megan Fox lookalikes on Instagram and a lot of other places. And you know, people have been requesting me to do a Megan Fox tutorial, and I thought that her makeup is only fitting for my channel since she did the makeup looks that she usually picks are with kind of these nice pinky nudie lips that are very early 2000s, and that's what my channel is all about, bringing that nostalgia back. I thought it would be cool to do like a talk through tutorial, you know, because I never really do that. Alright, so we're not going to worry about my complexion yet. My foundation is on, but I do plan on warming up my face because I look a little ghostly. So yeah, I want to look nice and tan soon. So I'll get on the ball with that in just a second. And I already did like a soft matte foundation. I always do my foundation on camera, so I'm pretty sure you guys know what I do. I always use the Maybelline 24-hour foundation. Until I get a new one, it'll be a lot better to do my foundation on camera because I've been using that and it's getting really repetitive. Okay, so for the eyes, I figured we'd go throwback and use the Lorac Pro Palette because we're gonna stick with a lot of neutral colors on the eyes. I do have contacts in. These are just gray contacts from a website called Pretty Fabulous. I buy all my contacts on that website because they're cheap and they ship fast. So I am using the Lorac Pro Palette, and I'm going to start off with the white color, and then also, yeah, white and cream, which is down to pan, but I still have a little bit of the edges, and I'm just going to put that all over the lid. So I'll show you guys right now, just going to place it all over the lid. It's going to be a super, super easy look. The makeup that I kind of chose for today is very similar to Pamela Anderson, but a lot toned down. But you guys will see the similarities. But once the makeup is all done, you're definitely going to see more of a Megan Fox resemblance. But like always, this is not a transformation. I just put the wig on to get as close as possible to the look. A lot of the times, I don't have the right wigs. Ugh, there's hairs. A lot of the times, I don't have the right wigs for my looks, and I still create the tutorial for you guys a lot of the times, but if I do have a wig similar, I'll wear it, you know what I mean? And I felt like this hair is very similar to Megan Fox. It's dark and it has a nice face frame, so that's why I did that. No shape, way, or form do I look like her. I wish, but I don't. So now that we got that part out of the way, let's do the tutorial. Okay, so as mentioned, I am just gonna take that cream color and place it all over my lid. And with that white color, I also am going to pop a little bit underneath the brow bone. You just want to take a small amount just so the light hits those areas, but not to the point where it's like, wow, that's a lot of white eyeshadow. We don't want to get too crazy there. Also going to take a little bit of that white and focus it right here on the inner corners, but not to the point where you have white highlighted inner corners, but just so you can see that there's a little bit of brightness there. Okay, great. That's all you want to do. You don't want to overdo it. And I'm just going to take the Maybelline Almond Satin Expert Wear little triad, and I'm taking a bit of the middle color, and it's just like a nude, so just take a champagne nude color, and I'm also going to do the same thing and just pat that in. I feel like there's a little bit of shimmer particles in this, and that's kind of what we want, so just place that, and I'm just using my finger Now I'm taking the going back in this palette and taking the color Taupe, and I'm going to just blend that into my crease before I start going in with the grays. And I am going to take Slate, but I feel like it's a little shimmery to blend out. So I am taking this color right here by Makeup Geek, and it is, drumroll, called Stealth. So I'm going to place that in my outer thirds of my lids with a more dense brush, not so fluffy, the outer thirds of the eye. I like that, and with that same other taupe color, you just want to merge the two a little bit together. Okay, now that we have these colors nice and blended in, I'm going to take a little bit of Slate and put that in the outer corners, and also mix a little bit of the black eyeshadow together just to get a little more sexier, smoky eye. Okay, that's basically how it's supposed to look. So just try to merge the colors together, like the taupe color and the grays, and then your smoky eye should be nearly complete. Just like that, Megan Fox likes to keep her eyeshadow in close proximity, or whoever does her eyeshadow. So just take a little bit of that champagne-y color and retouch those highlighted areas. And if you have to retouch a little bit of the gray, go ahead and do that. Really am liking this. Now what you're going to do is, with that same taupe color, you are going to take a little bit on the lower lash line. Okay, so that's looking really good. The next part is liquid eyeliner and tight lining your eyes a bit. Okay, so I am going to take this Ulta Beauty Micro Felt Tip Liner because it creates a very small, tiny line. You're just going to create a very, very thin line. Hey, that is looking really good. What you're gonna wanna do is take a little bit of a small detailed brush like this and take some of your black and smoke that out a bit, because you don't want it to look too perfect, I guess. So you might wanna smoke the end out. Definitely want to smoke it out to the point where it flares out in the end. So you'll just take your brush and blend it out. Okay, and now what you're going to want to do is take a black eyeliner and line your waterline. Like that. And now we're going to move on to lashes. So what I am going to do is take these lashes right here. These are the Natural Ardell lashes. I'm going to use these to stick them on. I'm just going to curl my lashes and put some mascara. And you want to focus a lot of this on the top and bottom, especially on the bottom too, because it looks like she did not neglect her bottom lash line. Still waiting for my lashes to dry. Okay, so since this video isn't years long, I'm just gonna use some bronzer, and then I'm going to take this palette right here, and it's called Trey Fab. I'm gonna use that as the blush as well. Okay, so now that I have most of the makeup, I'm going to do the signature pout. She has these amazing, like, just very pretty lips. So I am taking Wear All by MAC, and I'm going to overline a little bit. That, and I'm going to take Cream Cup by MAC and place that right in the center. This one is Pop by Smashbox and place that over everything. Okay, you guys, so that is it for my Megan Fox tutorial today. I hope you guys enjoyed the simple glam smoky eye with a nice glossy lip. It's very wearable for every day, and especially if you want to bring out your inner Megan Fox. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.